Tony, it's great to see you here at London Film and Comic Con Winter. How have you been enjoying it so far today?
It's been great. It's been very busy. It's been some amazing costumes. I might keep looking over that way because people keep walking past in extraordinary costumes. I've seen a couple of stormtroopers. It's great. Yeah. I've been signing away. It's been fun. Right.
And you, of course, we know you for Game of Thrones most recently, and you have some great costumes in that as well, don't you? And you had the purple wedding this year as well, at which you were pelted with stuff, weren't you?
I was pelted with stale bread rolls. The thing about that is it looks lovely and everything, but that costume is a Northman's costume. So it's meant for the winter up north. We were in Dubrovnik in 40 degrees heat, and I juggled for hours in front of everyone. Everyone just sort of going, is that your juggling? Is that your best juggling? I was dying of the heat, but it was very good fun. It was great fun.
Tell me a little bit about behind the scenes on filming that.
Well, that was extraordinary because I think they don't often collect that many casts together for a scene like that, because it was people from all over coming together for the wedding. So you had all of the royal family, you had everyone was there, it was amazing. So the green room was extraordinary. You've got sort of Charles Dance, we know a bit, and you've got the Dame, you've got it's just extraordinary fun. A lot of Scrabble was played because lots of people were sat miles away here and miles away there, so you could spend half of the week and never get to film. A lot of Scrabble was passed around on iPads over that time. Backgammon.
Really?
Yeah.
And who would you say was the backgammon or Scrabble champ of Game of Thrones?
Dame Diana. Dame Diana Rigg is extraordinary at backgammon, and she's not bad at crosswords either. I beat her twice at backgammon, and then she got the measure of me, and I think I lost 10 games in a row after that. That was it. She's the master. She's excellent.
A woman not to be beaten, though.
Of
course, obviously, you're getting pelted because of Joffrey. You've been dunked in wine because of Joffrey as well. So how satisfying was it to see his death on screen?
I think it was very satisfying, but I think a lot of people felt the same way. I think everyone's been dying for him to die for so long that when he actually died, there was this moment of yes, and then you go, but there's no more Joffrey. Joffrey's gone. What now? Who's going to be the evil one? I'm sure that they'll get someone to fill that gap. But yeah, it was sort of, triumphant, but a little bit of regret in there as well. That's it. Joffrey's done now.
And talk about nasty pieces of work. Littlefinger as well, who you met your end by, didn't you?
Absolutely, yes. I mean, I was tricked. I like to think that Dontos did it for good reasons. I mean, he also did it for some gold and some booze, I'm sure, but there's no way he was clever enough or sober enough to work out what was going on. And I think Littlefinger is now the big bad of the show. He's certainly one of them. There's a few out there. No one's that nice in Game of Thrones. There's a few, but the ones that are don't hang around for very long. So yeah, I think he's the one to watch now.
What do you think is going to happen with Sansa and Littlefinger going forward now?
Well, I hope that she, I have no idea, but I hope that she comes to her senses and realises. I think she's probably playing him along a bit. I think she knows that if she stays friends with him, then she probably won't get killed off too quickly.
Talking about getting killed off, of course, we had in the Mountain versus the Viper episode that spectacularly gruesome fight, didn't we? What was your reaction when you saw that on screen?
It was extraordinary. I knew it was going to happen because I had some episode scripts knocking around, you never know what episode things are going to happen in, so I kind of knew what was going to happen. I even knew specifically the thing with the eyes and the head was going to happen, but nothing prepared me for that. It's like I knew about Joffrey's death, but it's still really, but the mountain and the Viper was extraordinary. It's some of the best, most shocking television I think I've ever seen. Yeah. It's great to be able to just sit back and watch it as a fan now, okay?
And finally, tell us a little bit about, because I know you've got some movies coming up, High Rise, which has got Tom Hiddleston in it and directed by Ben Wheatley, and also Trespass Against Us.
Yeah, Trespass Against Us is a film about travellers set in the West Country. It's good. It's very, very dark. I suppose it's comic as well, but it's quite dark. It's a bit kitchen sink, and it stars Michael Fassbender, Brendan Gleeson, Sean Harris. Amazing cast. So we all just basically lived on a campsite for the whole of that, for half of the summer. I think that'll be out next year. And then High Rise is taken from the J.G. Ballard novel. Ben Wheatley's directing. So if you've read the book, you know how bleak that is. Imagine that paired up with Ben Wheatley. It's going to be quite bleak. And that's got Tom Hiddleston in it, and Luke Evans, and Sienna Miller, and Jeremy Irons. It's the cast goes on and on and on. And a lot of people that Ben has worked with before, like myself, and Peter Ferdinando's here today, and dozens of people who you'd recognise. And that's, I think, out next year as well. Yeah.
Can't wait to see them. Thanks so much for talking to us today,
welcome.
Tony.
You're welcome.